is long. There are mountains in our way, but we climb the stairs every day. Mountains in our way, but we climb.
Go. Brandon, and my little girl Brittany. Glad to be here.
I'm Eugene, this is my wife Patty, and this is my little boy, Patrick.
Clay Corn, and I'm not married and I don't have any children, and I'm really, really happy about that. And I'm moving to Macon, Georgia on Wednesday to teach at a private school, and then I'm hoping to go to graduate school. And
I heard it too, Daddy.
My name's Richard Johnson. This is my fiancée, Lou Ann Arrington. Presently, I'm working for the City of Rainbow City as a firefighter. I coach high school football at Christian Christian. Work for Gold City.
Richard, read your lines!
Gold City Music, part-time. She's a school teacher for the City of Gadsden at Stripling Elementary. We plan to get married pretty soon. Hopefully in 20 years or 10 years from now, we'll have some kids. I guess that's about it. Thank you.
Joel Angel, this is my wife, Tina.
Hello.
Goodbye. My name is Michael. And I'm Richard Stapleton. This is my wife, Emily.
What'd you say, Joel?
One more time.
Kim Sears.
Rusty Sears.
Rusty and Kim Sears, formerly Kim DeVos. You'll remember.
I'm Jeff. This is my daughter, Jamie. She's 3. I work at TVA, still live here.
Husband Alan here, no kids yet. Beverly, Brian, Ellen, Luke, we're easily now living in Prattville, and here Montgomery, and I stay at home and take care of our baby.
Okay, I'm Julie Dunn Walker. I've been married 8 years to Doug Walker. These are my two children, Stephen and Jennifer. We live here in Glencoe.
Hi, I'm Martin Gray. This is my wife, Rochelle. We live down in Birmingham.
Susan Roper Morris. This is my husband, Rod Morris. And this is my daughter, Laura. And I'm sorry she's not very friendly, and she won't look at the camera.
We live in Gadsden now.
Boy Josh, he's home.
Two and a half years old.
We live in Ball Plain, Alabama.
I think it's cute.
What else can I say?
Thank you.
say.
Not everything, Troy.
Let's see. This is not going to be on America's Most Wanted or anything, is it? All right. I work for Huff International, single. No wife, kids, or miscellaneous. I'm here to harass Gray Black. Fly a little corporate jet for Huff International. Keeps me real busy.
Your name is?
Troy Tucker. That's it.
I'm single now. I'm single. I've been single. June 4th. That's all you need to know.
Thank you.
terminable
disease.
It's called bacheloritis. I can't find anyone stupid enough to marry me, but I'm having a great time here. It's great to see everybody. Roll Tide, go Braves.
I'm Dawn Bryant Beers, and this one has Mark, and we're having a marvelous time getting rained on. That's good.
Barbara Beth, this is me, Barbara Forrest. This is my son, Matthew. My husband couldn't make it this afternoon, but we'll be joining us.
Just introduce your family.
I'm Eric. This is Kristen. This is my daughter Brooke.
This is Jan. And this is Barry. 10-year class reunion, 1993. So far, I've had my stomach poked and told that I have no gut. I've had my hair poked to bring out the gray hairs here. So it's been a lot of fun. I want to do this again tonight. I've had about 3 margaritas, so check back with me later. And I think we're going to sign off now. See ya.
Hi, I'm Karen and Greg Atkinson.
Ex-Deacons.
Yeah, we're living in Lexington, Kentucky. We have no children, and that's awesome. Bye.
But a happy life.
Introduce yourself.
Okay, I'm Dana Johnson. She's the music. This is Kyle, my husband, and this is Rachel. She's 3, and we're just about 10 years old, and 14 years ago.
My name's David Gunner, my wife, Amy Gunner, and Joanna Gunner, my daughter, is 10 months old, can't be here. She's at work, babysitting the city, and she's a certified mechanic, and has been working in the local dealership here in town. Getting soaking wet and pouring rain, having a good time, glad to see everybody.
Hi, I'm Cindy Kemp, I'm married to Joey Kemp. This is my daughter, Caitlin, and I live in Birmingham now. That's about it.
Hey Mom, hey Dad, this is Shannon Rampey, single and loving. Thank you. Oh, what's that?
Happy
second.
Well, you can't do that. You can get down.
way my hand was. Without emotion, that just
pours. It's fine.
talk about nobody, you know.
And I need to ride with him.
That's a good guy.
He was in the military doing that. Now he's a private investigator in Washington, D.C. They couldn't locate him.
Thank you. very, very hard job. Everybody's worked hard. I'm really glad that we have a great turnout. We have like 65 or 66 class members that responded, which is over 50%, which was really good for our first time for a reunion. There's some people that we were unable to contact. We did not find R.L. Adams, and we couldn't find Kim Harden. But other than that, somebody got a response letter that we sent out, because those are the only two that we couldn't find. But you're here. Persevere. Some people really traveled a long way to be here. Some people gave up vacation time to be here. Some people are close to going to Alaska on remote, but they were able to be here. Some people put a lot of effort in even attending to go along with the hard work that we've been doing. And so you're to be commended also. We did invite the senior sponsors to attend. Mr. Finley's out of town. He is still at Glencoe High School, but was in the process of hopefully getting on at the junior college to teach history. He should have known about whether he got the job last week or so, in the past 2 weeks. So he may be going to the junior college full time, but right now he still is at Glencoe. Malcolm Edge is retired. Everybody knew he was retired. He was unable to attend. He was afraid to leave his mother at home by herself for such a long time tonight. So he decided, but he wanted to wish everybody well and said he remembered everybody. So. Mary Ann Clayton, she was unable to attend. She's still at Glencoe. Debbie Handy's still at Glencoe. Oh, and Mary Boyd. Mary Boyd's out of town. She sent a letter that she wanted to read. She retired from Glencoe. She just stays busy with her church and with her friends. And she said that she pulled out her annual and could remember everybody and how well they typed or didn't type. So she's still Mary Boyd. She's still the same Mary Boyd. I need to go ahead and tell that Buffalo Rock donated a lot of things for us today, especially the picnic, the banner, and the soda pops, and the cups, and the Coke. I was in the Air Force for 4 years, and then I got out and I lived with Angie Free Carter in Birmingham for a while, and then I came back here and I started to work with the City of Guests, and I was there for almost 5 years, and Thursday was my last day there, and this Wednesday I'm moving to Macon, accepting the teaching position, so that's what I'll be doing. So I barely got under the wire here.
I'm
Sonia.
Yay!
Oh gosh, there's so many people I need to thank. Carl by May, Terry Tona, Susan Morris.
Who's that?
I would call and I'd say, hey, I need you to do this. And quickly it was done. Terry Tona made several telephone calls to get addresses. Susan Morris outdone herself helping.
Calling Carl.
Everybody that come up to me and said, can I help do anything, that done little things. We don't leave anybody out. We just want to thank everybody that helped get addresses or do what. Mike Fisher again for the Cubs. He overdid himself there. I haven't done anything. I've been in Gadsden forever. I went to work at the Exchange Bank 2 years after we graduated. Worked there for 4 years, and then I went to work at the Baptist Hospital where I am now. I've probably seen everyone, if not most of you, there. Other than that, I'm not married. I have no children.
Thank God.
None. Zero. Children.
Not that you know of.
Maybe one day. Maybe. I believe I would know that. Who said that I know of? I believe I would know that. Who's next?
Good evening, everybody. I'm glad y'all was able to attend tonight, and this park is
this morning. We've really enjoyed getting this together, where we could all be together for 10 years after our day of graduation. We have our school president here tonight, and I'm really glad to have him all the way from New Mexico. There are several of you that made long journeys to make it here tonight, and I appreciate it. I'm married and I got two kids, currently working for the city of Glencoe. But I'm glad to be back in the Glencoe area. Greg, would you come down here for a few moments, please, and give us a word about the Yankees? Well, you'll be glad to know that in New Mexico, they're now properly informed of the War of Northern Aggression. Taught them well. We did. But yeah, I went down to the great Auburn University, where I have the best paid football players in the state. And got out of there, went in the Army, went and slugged it out with the Iraqis. Actually, we went and gathered up their white handkerchiefs and underwear and whatever else they'd used to surrender with. And ended up in New Mexico, and I was fighting to get a transfer back, and I was all set for Oxford, Mississippi. And I met that raven-haired girl back there in the corner. Told her she had pretty hair. 6 months later, here I am, stuck in New Mexico, no way out. And that beautiful hair now ends up in my drains every morning, clogging my sink. Little did I know, but that's the way things go, and I'll pay for that all the way back. Great to see everybody. I got to be the bad guy, kind of put a damper on things, but it's great to see everybody. Like a lot of us, I went away right after high school, didn't stick around, so some of you have seen it for the first time in 10 years. And when you've done that, you know how important it is to keep contact, to see everybody. And so I encourage everyone to stay in touch, let somebody know where you are so we can do this again in 15 or 20 years, and watch us all become fatter and fatter through the years. And just like to take a minute on your own time to remember, you know, three of us who couldn't be here, and that's, of course, Jenna and Jeff and Ricky Cottle. And think of them, and hopefully we won't have any more of those types of events, and we'll see the same smiling faces. Other than that, for a small fee, I'm available for any impression you might want of any teachers.
Mr. Reed!
Well, David Arledge, he told me Coach Burles, he's just some good things for him. Like in basketball, I told him he's half a man, and then he was nothing. The one thing about Coach Burles, since he played football, you understand, he won't give you more stars, but he will replace the ones you lose. Get pulled out. But think about Stephen LaFollette, he's a Pharaoh like Mr. Black. He comes in here, he thinks he owns a place wearing plaid pants. He's apathetic.
One more, do it again.
Well, what I'm older now is, y'all remember Coach Brill. And all of them don't have on those real tight polyester pants like he wore. What he was going to do was, he was going to tell you about boron and nickel and cadmium and how they came together in photosynthesis. But every time he'd say that type thing, old Joel, he'd sit back here and kind of giggle, you know. Well, that's what I ain't going to do, but I got to get off the stage. Like I say, for a small fee, can you and my wife come out to buy a house, and we'll take any donation from my house. You got it.
Thank you, Greg.
No boy's gonna get you, Richard.
I guess I'm the last one on the committee. I guess they saved the best for last. I don't know what to say about that. But I just wanted to get up and say a few things that's happened over the past 10 years. We've got several people that's here that's involved in some of the the tragic things that's happened over the past 10 years. I didn't want to get up here and kind of down, make everybody feel down, but Keith Chambers, he works for NASA. And, you know, we know we had the shuttle crash, and
it was his fault.
Now, I'm not making fun of him. I'm just, you know, Keith told me that a lot of people at NASA really affected them, you know, mentally, and had people to retire early because of it. We've got several people in here. I know one, Greg, that was over in the Persian Gulf War, and we had several that was on standby ready to go. And I appreciate all that. And of course, we've had a lot of different things that's happened when going dead. But as Greg mentioned, we lost another classmate. I work for the city of Rainbow City as a firefighter. And I went into work one morning and I was looking at some pictures that a guy had committed suicide that night or the day before. And I was flipping through the pictures and it was Ricky Collin. And it shocked me because I had no idea that he would do something like that. About 11 months prior to the day he shot himself, it had an aneurysm on the brain. I was one of the medics that was on the scene, and if you've never seen anybody that is totally out of it, it's frightening. And when it's one of your own classmates, you're thinking, you know, man, I gotta do something to save this boy. But it affected his walking and talking. And about 9 months after that happened, he became a Christian and joined White's Chapel Baptist Church. You would not believe that boy. He was walking, talking just like we are today, normal. He walked a little awkward, but hey, you couldn't tell it. We thought everything was going fine with him. And nobody knows how bad something gets when somebody takes their own life. And before I close, I just want to tell you a little bit about myself. I'm a firefighter at Rainbow City. I coach high school football at Coosa Christian. I work for Gold City Gospel Group on my off days from the fire department. I'm engaged to Lou Ann Arrington. She teaches school at Strickland Elementary. She hates it. But in closing, I'd like to read a verse out of the Bible that no matter how hard things get, I mean, God's never going to put anything on it that you can't stand. I mean, I know two adults right now that's going through a lot of stuff. They've lost two sons and a granddaddy and a father. Most of you know the Allison. Davy Allison. I talked with his uncle Donnie in Talladega, and he was telling me that if it wasn't for the friends and support and our Lord Jesus Christ, they wouldn't make it. But I want to read this verse out of the Bible. It says, "As we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are the called according to his purpose." The reason I want to say that is everybody's got a purpose for being here. We've got football coaches, we have electricians, we have NASA technicians, we have nurses. I don't think we have any doctors. We have police officers, we have a few narcs, we won't call their names. And you know, like I said, everybody's got a purpose for being here. And hey, y'all got my number, and bless God, do not give Sonya Lashley your beeper number. I was in the movies the other night at 10:30 and my pager goes off. Sonya, this is Richard, call me.
No, other way around.
Richard, this is Sonya. But, I appreciate everybody being here. We had a lot of fun getting this together. It's coming from where I come from. I knew he would get something together this quick and easy. But I really appreciate everybody coming. We've had a lot of people that's changed just a little bit. We had people change a lot. But I appreciate y'all coming out. If there's anything I can ever do for you, y'all know where I live. You know my phone number. I still live the same place for the time being. Still got the same phone number. I will not give you my beeper number.
She loves giving it to you.
Thank you.
Both nations, for the most changed female here tonight, the class member, the most changed female.
Kathy Hayes.
Kathy Hayes. Okay, we got Kathy Hayes, who else? Debbie Kilgo, Debbie Hayes Wenzel.
Kathy has hair now.
I need to come up here. And Terry Tola. Debbie Kilgo.
Well, I should have worn marriage, surely you got the money. she has four children.
Four?
Now, because we have so many with food, we have to recognize we have a lot of class members who stop us. Okay, David Gunner, you've already won an award, so you can't win this one. Okay, who was married the most recent?
Angie Free.
Has anybody been married prior to the end of June?
2 years qualified?
Or since the end of June?
Robert Griffin.
Griffin's been married forever.
No, he hasn't either.
Angie Free Carter has been the most recent. In the
future.
Yes, his husband, her husband's in the back. He's the one that's got this contraption coming out of his knee, and so he's not able to walk.
That's how she called him.
Less than a month, and he's, you know. Okay, now we're going to marry the longest. The only thing we can find Washington, D.C. He's out of the Army. He's not guarding the White House like everybody thinks he is. He's not. He's out, and he's a private investigator in Washington.
And one of you supply airplane for the vessel.
If you can speak loud enough, or if you can't, if you can do it to the microphone, that's fine. We want everybody
to
stand up and introduce your spouse and their guests
if they're
with, and let everybody.
That girl ain't riding with him. I've been married before. And you start at a triangle. Your wife's on the left, you're on the right, you're going towards the top. So the closer you get, closer.
Sure.
All right. Thanks, Joel. I appreciate that. You don't know, do you? But I think the closer you get to the Lord, the closer you marry. And you start on the left, and your wife starts on the right, and y'all work towards that point. And the closer you get, the more trust you get in each other, and the less problems you're going to have.
A hell of a lot fatter. It's my life, April. I've been married 5 years. I went to Jack State. I graduated there. I was an Army officer and lived in Hawaii for a while. I now live in Hawaii and I work. I now live in Birmingham and I work for IDS American Express. It's good to see everybody. A lot of folks hadn't changed. James Snell, you know, I was like, who's this guy? So, but it's great to see everybody.
We've been married 3 years. I went to Jackson State in Alabama, got a master's at Alabama, and I'm teaching school at Southside. Don't get on me, I'm a traitor. So that's all I've been doing is coaching against Glencoe for 5 years.
Boo!
My name's Mark Gray, this is my wife Rochelle, and I'm living in Birmingham working with American General Finance, and I graduated from the University of Alabama, and I've been married 4 years, and we're having our first baby in February.
Right.
If you can, let Barry, come up here because it's really hard to hear.
Barry Bowen, all right.
Hello.
Turn the power
on. And this is my lovely guest, Jan.
Hi, Jan.
Is this working?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. This is my lovely guest, Jan. We date about once every 10 years. We're dating again now, so. I went to Jack State, got the marketing degree, doing the sales thing. I sell computers for Maricom Systems in Birmingham. Didn't get married yet. It's a nice institution. I want to try it one day. And that's about it. Just working and living in Birmingham and just coming out and hanging out with you guys. It's good to see everybody.
Went to Harvard on the Hill for 2 years after getting out of school. Been with United Parcel Service for 9 years. Been married to my lovely wife, Donna, for South Central Bell. We live here in Gadsden. No kids. And maybe some someday. Enjoy seeing all y'all.
My husband, Richard Payne. I graduated from Jacksonville State. We live in Alma, Louisiana now, and I work for the USDA Department of I'm Callie Zahorzak Kane. This is my husband, Richard. I graduated from Jacksonville State, and I now work for the USDA Sugarcane Research Lab in Alma, Louisiana. And we've been down there for 5 years.
I do
have a dog.
Hello, I'm Joel. Nice to see everybody. I just took your finger out of my butt, David. Married to my lovely wife for 6 years. We have no kids. 3. Maybe not for 3 more, but thank you.
I'm married to Sarah for 5 years. I got a 3.5-year-old little girl, and I'm currently working for TVA as a lineman.
Shortly after I graduated, I went in the United States Navy, served 4 years. I've been going to Auburn University for the past 5 years. I graduate next year. I hope I'm in hotel restaurant management, landscape architecture.
Okay. I'm Karen Jenkins Atkinson. I'm married to Greg Atkinson, my high school sweetheart. We've been married over 5 years. We have no children and no pets. So, no responsibilities at all. That's why I've seen everyone. And I work at a pharmacy. We live in Lexington, Kentucky. And I'm still sending my husband through school, so hopefully he'll be out soon.
I'm Bree Carter. I just got married. My husband is Mike Carter. He works for Marathon Oil Company. We live in Birmingham. I've got two stepchildren. One is Greg, who's 15, and Missy's 13. So on our next reunion, I'll probably, Mike could be the first grandmother. But I have a mobile home financing company that I started, and I'm also doing training programs for McCray's department store, so might see somebody in there. And it's good to see y'all. After I got out of high school, I moved to Birmingham and went to UAB, and I got a BS degree in marketing and an MBA from UAB, and I still come home to visit whenever I can. Good to see y'all.
Hello, it's Barney. Glad to see everyone. I'm going to school, still running the motels, and listen, I got to do a plug. I've got a radio show every day, Monday through Thursday, 1:30 to 3 on 91.5 FM. Hope you'll listen sometime.
I'm divorced. I have an 8-year-old daughter named Amanda. I graduated from Jacksonville State University, and I'm an accountant for Weber Diversified in Gadsden.
The picnic today, you missed a visit by Don Ritchie came by to see us today, and it's good to see all y'all down there today, and glad you came by, right? When the picnic was over, I went by. I can tell you one thing, boys, I guarantee you I went by Coach Yancey's house today. That wild man's at home, and I talked to him for a little while. He said, I hope y'all have a good time. He told me to send you all his best wishes. I don't have any wives or children that I know of. I am presently employed by the Jefferson County Board of Education. I'm a teacher and head basketball coach at West Jefferson High School. I have a perfect record. It's my first year. We haven't played yet. It has just really been a joy, though, actually, in all seriousness, to see everybody here tonight. And for those of you who put it together, my eternal thanks and gratitude. You did an outstanding job. It's good to see everybody here tonight.
I'm married Joey, and I'm sure y'all seen him running around. We have a 3.5-month-old little girl named Caitlin, and we lived in North Carolina for about 3 years, and now we're back in Birmingham, and it's really nice to be back close to home. I work for Bell South, and I've been there for 5 years, and
I'm Debbie Kilgo Heflin, and I'm married to David Heflin. A lot of you know him, and we have one daughter. Her name is Emily Ann, and she's beautiful. And we lived in Jacksonville, Florida for 3 years, where David went to seminary, and then we moved to Georgia. We moved to Alabama, back to Georgia, and He is the pastor at Prior Winfield Baptist Church, and I'm a mommy. I stay home with Emily, and I love that. And if some of you are not too hungover to come to church tomorrow, I'll come to David's church.
Wow, Alan, and my parents are. I got two beautiful little girls, Brittany 10 and Hannah 6, and I'm as proud as them as more than I can describe. You know, they're beautiful little girls, and we're still out in Hoax Bluff, and I work for Farron's Tree Service at Trim Tree.
That's my wife back there in the back. We got married while we were in the country of Great Britain. I've got two children, a little boy named 6 and a little girl 3, Nathan and Brandy. I'm currently going to my second university, Troy State, and pretty soon I'll be going to my third when I get up to Alaska. And I've really enjoyed seeing all of you. Thanks.
My name's Marty Link. Y'all remember me? And
no.
I've got two children, a boy 7, a boy 4. I'm still married to the same woman, my wife Cheryl. When I was 20 years old, the Lord seemed fit to save me. But the most significant change in my life came about a year and a half ago when I was called to be a preacher. And that's currently what I'm working toward doing, serving my Lord.
Amen.
I'm Don Bryant, Beers now.
Nope, Don.
Yeah. And I guess y'all will never guess what I do for a living.
She sings! Yeah. Sing the song!
She's a preacher!
Sing!
I was gonna sing You Light Up My Life, but
Do it!
Anyway, I've been married for 9 years to the same guy I met on the road. I was in a band, met him, and all you guys, and I was sweethearts with from like first grade on. Won't believe that I only knew him for 8 weeks and married him, and I'm still married to the same guy for 9 years, it's true. But we have an album coming out in January. The name of our band is called Cinnabar, S-Y-N-A-B-A-R, and I hope y'all will look for it in the record stores. I hope to be what I've always wanted to be, and that's a big success, and I appreciate it. I really love seeing all you guys. I appreciate y'all inviting me and having me here today.
Julie Dunn Walker. I've been married to Doug Walker for 8 years. We have a set of twins, Stephen and Jennifer. Gibby's told everybody in the world about them. They're 5 years old. I work with the Department of Education, with the Adult Vocational Rehabilitation Service. The counselor I work with is for the mentally ill and drug and alcohol abuse. So if you need any help, I can help you.
I went up to Gaston State after I graduated, and then from there transferred to Auburn and graduated from Auburn University. And so did my husband Paul. That's where I met him. He's in the back. We have two beautiful little boys, William 3 and a half and Michael 7 months. I'm also at home, staying home with them. I'm not a stay-at-home mother. I'm hardly ever home, but I'm not working, and I'm really enjoying spending time with them. My husband works in Hope's Bluff also for Hubert Offer Construction. We moved back to Gadsden almost 5 years ago. We lived in Auburn for a little while and Birmingham for a little while after we got married and wound up back in Gadsden, which was a big surprise for all of us, but it's great to be back.
Okay. Used to be Stephanie Thompson, been married for almost 5 years. And I think I'm kin to David Gunner because he changes wives about like I change jobs. I taught for a while, and then I worked for a trolling company, got my MBA after I graduated from Auburn. Taught for a while, then worked at a petroleum company, then now work for Delta, and I'm fixing to switch jobs to go to UPS. But and we do have a dog with no children, a big Doberman, big runs dog. With us.
Yes.
My husband's been training for a marathon. He's been running about 22 miles. I've got up to 16. That's about our life now, as you can expect. But that's about it. Oh, wait a minute. Before we go, I think we should all sometime have a standing ovation for the crowd that got all this together, because I don't know about y'all, but I've been to other high school reunions and they're nothing like this. It was so well planned and well organized. I think we should give them all a hand.
I've been married for over 5 years. Dwayne Odom. I met him in Birmingham. He was living in Atlanta. I work for Horn Barlow Properties. I'm a property manager for an apartment complex in Atlanta. We have two Dobermans, one child that's 18 months old that was the one pitching the fit at the picnic today. You saw him. I went to school for 2 years and I worked at Stone Mountain Park for 3 years in Georgia.
This is my husband Kyle here in the Payless Yardbus. If you know him, we've been married for 7 years. We have a beautiful daughter. She's 3 years old. Her name is Rachel. I am a business manager for a surgeon here in Gadsden. Kyle works with me here. Like I said, we've been married 7 years. We lived in Virginia for a year. We've been here 6 years. And I'm working to the end of this month, and then I'm going to be a full-time mom. So I'm really happy about that. And it's just good seeing all y'all, and look forward to seeing you in 2 more years.
I didn't actually go to Glencoe High School, but I feel like I know some of you people. Actually, I'm married to formerly Kim DeMoss, but unlike Doug, I decided to keep my maiden name. I'm in industrial sales. Kim has recently become a full-time mom. We decided we'd try this for a little while. Up until about a month ago, she was a paralegal secretary. We have two wonderful children, one of which 8 years old, 8-year-old son, and a 16-month-old son. I would like to thank everybody for being here. I've had a wonderful time. I feel like I know you people, and I will certainly be here next time. Thank you.
For everybody that don't know me, my name's David Gunner.
No, I'm sorry. I do have a job. I'm a policeman.
Okay.
I never worked, so it seemed like one. Yeah. And been to college just long enough to make me think I know everything. And everybody.
I'm James Quarles, or as everybody knows me as LaRue. I've been married to my wife, love, for 4 years now, going on our 5th year. I moved to Sylacauga when we first got married, worked for Sharon Williams, hated every minute of it, came back, got my degree in mechanical design, and I'm looking for employment. So if anybody needs an AutoCAD draft, I'm here.
I've been married to Larry Walker for 4 years. We've got a little girl. She'll be 3 in October. Her name is Heather. I work for Alpha Insurance Company in East Gadsden as a secretary.
I'm Allison Lee, and I've been married almost 10 years. In 2 weeks, I'll be married 10 years. Alan, which I was dating when we were all in high school. And I have 2 boys, an 8-year-old and a 3-year-old. I'm a pharmacy technician, and that's about all.
I'm a Florence Beth. After high school, I went into the Air Force active duty for 6 years. That's where I met my husband, Mike. We've been married almost 7 years. We have one son. His name is Matthew. He's 4 years old. Mike is currently an auto mechanic for the U.S. government at the post office. And I work in Birmingham for 3 doctors, and it's not fun sometimes.
I'm Carly LeBron Keith, and I am divorced. I have a beautiful little boy, though, that's 4 years old, that a lot of you saw this evening. I am dating this gentleman over here that made me
for a year.
I live in Birmingham, and I've worked at White GMC Trucks for 2 years. Great seeing everybody.
Because I'm the most in charge here. That's right. I don't work for NASA, though, by the way. I work for the Defense Intelligence Agency. I'm an electrical engineer, graduated in 1989 from Auburn University. Still singing?
Here, Troy Tucker, Carmel Burgess, Stanley Grego. Come on.
Stanley Grego, I don't know how many of y'all remember me, but I've been married for 8 years. I've got a little boy, 17 months old. Best-looking little boy on the playground today. One throwing a fit. I love him dearly. And I work here in Glencoe. Been there in the same country for 10 years. And staying here forever, I guess.
I'm Troy, and I still like Susan. And I work with Angie. That's good.
Okay, I'm Troy Tucker. I was in Coast Guard for 6 years, traveled all around, got tired of flying in the backseat of helicopters, so I went to flight school, and now fly a little corporate jet in Albertville and I travel a lot. It was really great seeing all of you. A lot of people have changed. It surprised me. And that's about it. It's great seeing y'all.
Got it again. Really brings back a lot of memories, and it's good to see a lot of people. Had a bad senior year in
football. What address you got me for, Sergeant?
Life goes on.
What address you got me
for? I worked for the government for about 8 years, and then Clinton got involved in a reduction in force. And,
okay, 3909.
I took my retirement out, and I opened up my own business now. And
West Megan.
It's real tough. The economy's bad, but everything's going to work out for the best. It's great to see a lot of you have.
And all I got is $100 bill.
No one has changed. No one has changed. Everybody must have great plastic surgeons around here. But anyway, it's good to see you.
Just get the picture right now. I'll get the video.
My best friend, hell, it used to be George Bush.